very warm welcome to, well, firstly, all the parents, governors and friends of BGS who are watching here in the theatre live, you're the lucky few. I'd like to say hello to all the students and staff who are watching, hello, from the Great Hall up there. There's about 600 of them up there. I'd like to say hello to, I believe it's Edwards House, who are currently waiting expectantly in the Mackay. They're going to be coming on to do their first performance of the evening in a moment. And of course, I'd like to extend a very warm welcome to all the parents, friends, my little niece who's one, who's watching from Portugal, and all these people who are watching on a live stream at home. Hopefully it's worked. So I just wanted to introduce really the context of the event. I mean, just over a year ago, when we heard that the Colston Hall was going to be closing for refurbishment, we thought, well, that's not a problem. House Singing will obviously continue, and we'll just move it somewhere else. So myself, Mr. Bennis, and a few other people looked around Bristol, and we soon discovered that BGS is a very big school, fitting 1,000 students and just over 1,000 parents in a single venue actually just isn't possible in the Bristol area. If anyone knows of a venue or runs a venue, please let us know for future years. We couldn't find one. So then we thought, well, we could give up, we could cancel for a couple of years, but that just isn't really, it's not really the BGS way. And so then we went back to basics, and we thought, we've got these fantastic spaces here at BGS, this new theatre, we've got the Great Hall that holds a few people, and then the Mackay. Could we possibly try and engineer an event where performances were happening from a theatre, being simultaneously to two different spaces on giant screens, World Cup style at the same time? It couldn't possibly work, could it? So we kind of put our heads together, and really what I wanted to say to you before the event starts is that this is a team event. So whilst you'll see the students performing on stage, this event is a testament to the ingenuity and hard work of many, many people here at BGS. I think a lot of schools wouldn't even try to do something so silly. So the event, it's true. I think Mr. Bennett said that to us in the planning meeting we had a week ago. Who else would try something like this? So the event you see tonight has been put together and made possible by a huge team of people behind the scenes. And I just want to very, very briefly thank some of them. There are, of course, the heads of houses and the house staff and the teaching staff who've worked tirelessly all day to prepare the students. There are the vocal coaches, my colleagues in the music department who've worked very, very hard to prepare the Year 7 choir and put together the backing tracks that you'll be hearing the houses singing to tonight, because sadly we couldn't fit a band on stage for logistical reasons. There are the facilities team who've organised and set up so many different areas of the school today. The catering team, the sound, the light, the visual, the camera team that you see here. The design team who organised the brochures. The IT team who solved the knotty problem of how on earth we get enough bandwidth to broadcast this to so many people online. So all of these people have collectively contributed to make this evening work, if indeed it does work, which we hope it will. I'd just like to say a personal thank you to all of them for helping House Singing to continue into 2018 and hopefully in a similar format next year. Two old Bristolians as our adjudicators this evening. I'm going to be introducing both of them at different stages of the evening. So first of all, we have the wonderful AJD. He is a genuine heartthrob. It's true. It's true. He coached his house to success in House Singing in 2000.
I didn't do that.
Oh, you didn't do that? Okay. But he was involved in House Singing back in the day. He's now in a band called The Wandering Hearts. They performed in Graceland recently. They performed at the Grand Ole Opry. They're shortly to start a sold-out tour of the UK. And he actually met a genuine fan outside, a girl in year five.
Yes, I meet AJ. I'm his biggest fan.
So did you sign her? You signed her guitar. I mean, that's what I did. So before we start, we're going to hear a song from our adjudicator, AJD.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Dom. I should probably just say before I start that it was actually a house music competition that gave me my introduction into singing in front of people way back in the 2000s, the early 2000s. So it's lovely to come back and do this again now. This song was written about cherry picking your beliefs, and despite the title, I like to think it's quite uplifting. It's called Nothing Happens When You Die.
Would you still be gentle? Would you still be wise? Would you look at strangers with sympathetic eyes? Would you smile through misfortune? Stare hopefully at the skies? Would you feel the same if I told you nothing happens when you die? If nothing happens when you die, would it be the same between you and I? Different views don't matter till they do. If nothing happens when you die, take the leap and sever the ties. I'd hate to think any less of you. Imagine the heights to which we all could fly. Imagine nothing happens when you die. Would you still be hateful? Would you still despise the differing opinions of husbands and their wives? Would you close your ears to progress to protect a pack of lies? Would your violence be worth it if nothing happens when you die? If nothing happens when you die, the same between you and I. Our different views don't matter till they do. If nothing happens when you die, take the leap and sever the ties. I'd hate to think any less of you. Imagine the heights to which we all could fly. Imagine nothing happens when you die. Imagine nothing happens when you die. Imagine nothing happens when you die.
Thank you very much, everyone. Enjoy the show.
Practicing our chants.
Why are we using a conductor? We're not Gunnar Wardner's, Goodman's, oh, I mean shorts.
Besides, why are you practicing before the day? Come on, you know that's against the rules. We're not Hilliards.
Yeah, I know, we're twice as good as Hilliards.
True, let's not practice, but we should start planning.
So does everyone know the house song?
Yeah, it's Good Grief by Bastille.
Why did we choose this song again?
Because, as a house, we all went through a period of mourning when we were narrowly pipped to the post by shorts. But now, we've come back and we're stronger and ready to win.
Yay!
Yes, come on!
The other house is best watch out.
So what plans have we got for this year's house singing then?
Well, from what we've heard, the houses expect us to do two main things.
Get the whole house to have fun and enjoy themselves and get the prefects dancing at the front with letters on their back.
So are we doing the exact same this year then?
Of course we are.
Sounds good. So what's the rest of our plans?
If you want to know the rest of our plans, make your way down to the Colson Hall.
No, it's in the Great Hall.
On live stream.
Anyway, you'll have to be there on the day to see the performance of the year.
Allez les bleus, 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 of the world.
Excited for your first house singing?
Yeah, I really like singing, so I think it's a really great opportunity.
So what do you think of the song then?
I think it's really good. I only heard it this morning, but overall it sounds really good.
Right now. And how are you preparing?
Well,
why did you choose the song?
We really like the song, and we think there's a lot that you can do with it, harmony-wise, and it's a cute song for a cute house.
Sorry.
We're preparing for a cute, like, star jumps or something.
Roll the anchor.
Yes, boys!
Overthinking and hey, yeah. Shiny beats.
Then the
harmony's going to come in.
We're all right together, people. We're all right together. We're all right together.
Brilliant. Guys, that's sounding really good.
Storms House.
And the song we'll be performing this year is Blinded by Your Grace by Stormzy.
We can all agree that we put a lot of consideration into choosing this song. Our focus was to basically come up with a new idea that's a bit out of the ordinary.
So something that we think is quite interesting about this song is the song has originated from a grime artist, which is completely different to the more traditional kind of songs that the house singing usually uses.
This song has a rap in it, which hopefully the judges will appreciate and see as something new, as opposed to the more mainstream kind of ways of singing, in-house singing.
Well, I think a lot of people would agree that Storms in his music, they can be quite inspirational sometimes, so we kind of wanted to go along with that vibe, really.
So he's from Croydon in London. He's a grime artist. He got 6 A stars at GCSE and was considering going to Oxford University, but this song's quite gospel-y. It's quite different to the usual pop songs.
Usually we're firm favourites, and seeing as we've won quite a few house singers recent years, I don't see why that should change.
Yeah, we're not going to reveal anything, but in terms of the structure of the song, it starts with the intro and then the rap comes in.
Coach Jess, so she'll be helping us throughout the day.
We're really excited for the day as well, not just the performance, because we hope that throughout all the years in Scots we can all mix and have a really enjoyable day.
It's also going to be a good day because it's our last house singing and Year 7's first, yeah, it's a good day.
The song itself is quite emotional, and so we want to connect with younger years every song.
Good luck to all the houses.
And we'll see you on the night.
one. I say prayed up, then I get the job done. Yeah, I'm Abigail's youth, but I'm God's son. But I'm up now, look at what God's done. Now real talk, look at what God did. On the main stage, running round topless. I film flips and I tell them that we got this. This is God's plan, they can never stop this. Like, wait right there, could you stop my verse? You saved this kid and I'm not your first. It's not by blood and it's not by birth. But oh my God, what a God I serve.
Lord, I've been broken, although I'm not worthy. You fix me, I'm blinded by your grace. You came and saved me. Lord, I've been broken, although I'm not worthy. You fix me, I'm blinded by your grace.
Take a moment to assemble. We've got year sevens coming from all over the school, so they'll take a second to get one. Thank you. Right, this is a humble tribute to the incomparable Michael Jackson, who sadly passed away a couple of years ago.
Started something. Said you wanna be started something. You have to be started. The greatest song showman. Is called This Is Me from The Greatest Showman. And it should be very, very good.
We chose the song because it has lots of hidden meaning behind it and we think it would be really good for our house.
We think it's going to be a good choir song that we can all sing together and, yeah, we're excited about it.
The lyrics, a lot of it's been talking about being yourself and I think a lot of people can relate to that at least on some level. So, yeah, it should be great. So, we're currently defending champions. But yeah, this one has potential to win. So,
yeah, we're going for 2-2, definitely.
I think Scots have.
Always looking to beat Scots. We've got some really good harmonies planned out, so we're looking forward to banging heads together. I think we're all looking forward to seeing how it all pans out on the day and how it will go.
It's going to go well.
It's going to go well.
I've thought of quite a few different ideas. One of them has been based on doing sections, and each section has a character, as it were.
We could have some surprises up our sleeves.
Yeah. We've got a full song out. Yeah. I think it would mean a lot to all of us, like, if we won in the last year. I think that would be a good way to go out.
Yeah, if we can leave on the way, that would be the best thing.
Beware
of
the houses.
Good shorts.
What a
You should be scared right now.
It's not going to be a happy ending for everyone.
The grass is always greener in the greenhouse.
This is going to be singing like it's never been house sung before.
There's always going to be a happy ending.
There's always a little bit of love.
Little bit of love.
I'm looking for a hat trick.
I just want to win.
I'd also like to win.
Same.
Who are we?
Green Army.
Thank you.
Are we going?
Who's going?
Why do we choose this year's song?
Why? Lottie and Steph's.
Yeah.
Vision.
Big fans.
Kay. This is so, raw.
Yeah. Right, let's try it again, Tash. Okay. Be natural. Right, so why did we choose this year's song?
Okay, let's go again.
Why do we choose this year's song? It's a good song. Lots of nice harmonies. Been exciting preparing it. Coming up with ideas. What does the song mean to you? It's just very upbeat. Counting stars.
Gun Republic.
Yeah.
Corny connotations of stars shining. Yeah.
Should we move on?
We've got lots of ideas, you know. Is that giving too much away?
It's quite a lot. It's quite well known as well.
It's like not nice about layers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Our track record, and how do we hope to perform at this year's event? I mean, hopefully we'll win. I'd be up for that.
We won like 3 years ago.
What a day.
And some fun actions. When we did it in year seven, it wasn't all in one day. We used to have loads of rehearsals. We all squeezed into Great Hall.
Squeezed. Any interesting tidbits? Tash? That's going to be good.
I'm so sorry.
Then?
I think we might have to do parts of this again. But I never did drama.
Steph has been on the choreography, that's going to be some incredible work. Possibly a lot of
I think
flashing.
We want it to be like visually interesting.
Yeah.
It's really embarrassing. The costumes
Cash
are bad.
Cash on costumes.
Now. Yeah.
Get excited. Compile all the best ideas. Into one mega idea. The arrangement. We're going to have many.
Lots of different layers. Cut out stars.
So. Shiny objects.
See here, like different.
Glitter.
Good energy. Actually, no, I just can't say this.
More colour is necessary. A lot of effort. A lot of planning. Yeah. Pull it out the bag.
Five. 32, 33, 34.
74, 75, 76, 77, 78. 102, 103. 1,054. Lottie, what are you doing?
Counting stars. Let's get the rest of the house ready.
Goodbye.
Don't clap.
Place at the right time. If you're in the front, your main job is to remember that you are not.
Thank you.
Wow, what a show.
Thank you, by the way, for your really enthusiastic support. Don't clap me, clap them. Yeah. So, we've got the inevitable pause for a moment while we wait for our two judges to tally up their totals. If need be, I'll make a casting vote, but hopefully they can decide on the top one. We're not going to announce the top three this year, because it's been so controversial in previous years. Everyone's so competitive at BGS that no one wants to come second, let alone third or fourth. So there will only be a winner this year. And the plan is this. Once the judges have come to their decision, we need to go and announce it in the Great Hall. And we're going to do it live. So myself and AJ will be running up to the Great Hall to announce a live winner up there. While that's happening, you're in the fortunate position of listening to our other judge, Mike Howie, who's another old Bristolian. He's a musical theatre singer who recently graduated from a musical theatre postgraduate degree in Cardiff, and he's now touring Holland, I think, in a play, as well as singing.
Austria.
Oh, Austria, sorry. not even vaguely close. Should have read my notes. So Mike will be coming down to perform for you in just a moment, and then we will be announcing the winner to you, but I'm afraid it's going to be after we've said it to the students. Sorry. We tried to broadcast from there back to here, but that was just too many links. So, ladies and gentlemen, and students up in the Great Hall, ladies and gentlemen, students, hello, up in the Great Hall. I'm pleased to say that we have, it was very, very tight, but we have a unanimous verdict. All three of us showed our winner to each other at the same time, and we've come up with the same one. So, AJ and myself will be going up to the Great Hall right now to announce the winner, challenge Annika style. And Mike, can we give a big round of applause to Mike Howie, who's going to come and perform for you.
Hello. Lovely to be back here. Such an honour to be asked to come back. I feel like I left about 2 seconds ago, but 7 years. I'm going to sing a song from a musical called Hamilton. A little popular show, and this is a song by King George. There's a bit at the end where I'd like you to all join in. It'll be obvious when it comes. Enjoy. You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember, despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back soon, you'll see. You'll remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say your love is raining and you can't go home. You'll be the one complaining when I am gone. And don't change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet submissive subject, my loyal royal subject, forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. You'll be back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war. For your love, for your praise, and I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we had. 'Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Everybody, da 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 da.
So, we have a winner. Now, before we announce it, Mike, fantastic performance, by the way. Hamilton, what a showman. The greatest showman, no less. No, Hamilton. Could I invite Mike to say a brief word on each of the houses? Would you like to do that? Yeah, absolutely. And then we'll announce the winner, who was unanimous, let's... Yes. Don't want to make any mistakes on there.
Well, it's changed a bit since my day. We used to do it over a few weeks, but to learn that they all did it all today is just phenomenal. So I think that deserves a massive round of applause. I think we can all agree across all of the houses, the sounds, the harmonies. Back in my day, it was just like, you know, just a tune and like the odd oo, the odd ah. But the harmonies today, I was blown away. I had goosebumps from multiple houses, so that was stunning. Obviously, I'm a yellow boy through and through. The little lights at the end, I was. That tick my boxes. Each of the houses.
Just for yourself.
Just each of the houses, cool. luckily I have a degree in improvising. So starting with the Blue House, my old rivals. Sadly, I have to say, they were really rather good. Well done, Mr. Edwards. Looking at you, one of the cameras. Well done. That's hard for me to say. the choreography, the entertainment value, right from the off with the video, classic Mr. Edwards. It was just brilliant. Great start to the show, always tough going first. So, phenomenal job. Glenn's house, beautiful arrangement. The choreography, the costumes, I like the little red sashes to indicate which house they were. Beautiful touch. Great vocals, really enjoyed that performance. And then we move on to Scott's house, Stormzy. Being a musical theatre actor, I'm well versed in Stormzy songs. can't say I've ever heard one before, but.
Grime and Lovey's a natural bedfellow, isn't it?
But I do live near Croydon, so. That one blew me away. I was not expecting much because I was like, grime? What's grime? But first have a soloist doing a rap. That was just phenomenal. So. But yeah, and then the harmonies that came in underneath, that's first goosebump moment of the night for me, I have to say. Back when I was at school, the Black House won the first 2 years. So I was just like, oh, going back to old times, the good start. Then we moved on to Short's house, and being a musical theatre actor, Greatest Showman, right up my street. Loved the touch of the beards, that was great. Got a little tick from me there. Choreography, great. I loved how it was split either side, so it was kind of one here, one there. Beautiful. The harmonies were stunning. Pasek and Paul, the writers of that, they know their stuff. The arrangement I thought was stunning. Incredible arrangement. Hilliard's house, happy ending, again a beautiful song, gorgeous harmonies, great splash of colour, right from the off, you knew who they were here, they made their statement and they did a phenomenal job. And then my old house, the Yellow House, they came on, they wowed us all, and I was like, they're doing a good job. And then the lights went out, the lights came on, their lights, goosebumps again. Phenomenal, phenomenal job. Massive congratulations to all the houses. I think they all excelled themselves. And I've just learned that I get to announce the winner to you guys. And the winner is... Short's house with This Is Me.
So, just before we bring on, as we bring on the winning house, come on guys, Can we give a big round of applause to the winners? And to our judges this evening, AJ. Well done, Shorts. One final thing before we all go home and collapse in a great big heap. Although it really isn't normally a good idea to single out individuals, I absolutely have to before we go. So behind the scenes, ever since a number of people came up with this crazy idea way back in the distant history of last academic year, since then, two people, Matt Bennett and Luke Goodman, have been working tirelessly behind the scenes. In fact, I don't think Matt's actually sat down since 8 o'clock this morning. He's been running up and down between the Great Hall. We traditionally have a competition at House Singing to see who can get the most pedometer steps. A bit sad, I know. But they have worked incredibly hard to make tonight work. So students in the Great Hall, if the feed's still going, and everyone here, can we please give a huge round of applause? Those two people. And well done, Shorts! Thank you very much, and good night. Have a safe journey.